I'm Nate from Design Squad, and today I'm working with Hannah.
I am 11 years old, and I love building and making stuff. Today, Nate and I are working on an invention.
Hannah and I have started talking about the problem of whale entanglement.
Lots of whales, especially blue whales, humpback whales, and gray whales, have been getting entangled in the ropes of crab pots.
Check it out. This is a video from the Timmy Boy. It's a crab fishing boat that sails out of Newport, Oregon, which is where I grew up. Bob is a crab fisherman. This is how fishing crews use pots to trap crabs at the bottom of the ocean. Lobsters are also trapped this way. A rope runs from the float to the crab pot. The float allows the crew to find the crab pot and grab the rope. The problem is that the whales can get tangled in the ropes. If we could get rid of the ropes, whales would be much safer. I have a couple ideas. I'm thinking about inventing something to hold the rope and float under the water. The rope and float would be held in place by a hook. After the crabs have been trapped, the hook would let go of the rope and the float, and then they would rise up to the surface so the crab pot could be put in the boat. With this idea, whales wouldn't get tangled in the ropes because the ropes and floats would be held in place underwater by the hook until they're needed. Today we're working on a prototype. It's like a rough draft to test the basic idea for a whale-saving crab pot.
So show me what you've done so far.
Well, I realized that my whale-saving crab pot will need to work underwater. So I found a food storage container that's watertight. And the hook needs to turn to release the float. So inside the container, I'm going to put a servo, which is a motor that can be commanded to turn and stop at certain positions, a battery that will power the servo, and a controller that will control the servo by sending it commands. I'm also going to use a small shaft that will turn the hook to release the rope and float. It will stick through the lid of the container. I attached the shaft to the servo with a special part that I designed and printed on a 3D printer. I also designed and 3D printed another special part to attach the servo to the lid of the container. The next thing I needed was some plastic to keep everything together. And that's where I'm at now.
I have some safety glasses for you to wear while we're machining.
These plastic pieces were cut from a kitchen cutting board, which was rough. But we need a smooth surface so that the parts will form a watertight seal. To make the pieces smooth, we're using a milling machine.
This operation we're doing is called facing. We're just making a nice level flat surface.
It's definitely like mowing your lawn because you're going back and forth.
All right, feel that surface. Let me know what you think. Smoother than earlier?
Yes.
That's what we want.
So what are we doing next?
Well, is squishing goopy stuff on other things fun?
Yes.
Okay, good.
Oh, this is fun. The goop that we're talking about is a special glue.
We should start with these screws here.
We're gonna put the cables and stuff inside and test it out in water.
We wanna make sure the flag keeps spinning, showing us the electronics are working.
Okay, down you go.
Yes!
It's working!
It's working!
Oh, good.
Yes!
Nice job, partner. Our next step is to make the release hook attached to our spinny mechanism. Right now, I am reproducing this hook design in the computer so that I can 3D print it. I've got to put a couple of holes through here. I'm hoping that you can drill those holes with the mill.
Yeah.
Awesome. Nice.
We're going to give it the directions using this programming language.
Is it supposed to be plugged in?
Maybe. There. Okay, good.
Yes, it works.
Let's take it to the pool.
Yes. The this bottle will act as a float. I really hope this works.
The rope and float are being held in place by this hook that's attached to the servo. I've programmed the controller to turn the servo after a minute, which will give me time to get to the bottom of the pool. When the servo turns, the hook will turn, and it will release the rope and float.
Oh, yes. It worked!
Our invention worked.
I'm so glad it did.
Me too. Next, I'm going to redesign this so it can be submerged in salt water for a long time. And I'm going to add a remote control so the fishing crew can control when the hook releases the rope and float. What do you think of inventing stuff?
I think it's super fun. I really love this.
Should we do it again sometime on another project?
Definitely.
In fact, you can invent stuff without me around. You can come use the tools. You know what to do.